I can see results, and I may not see results per se physically, because a lot of what I do or a lot of the work that I'm involved in is below the ground. It's something you don't see. You only see it on paper, or you only see it through data. Taking a site that was maybe a blighted property and the neighborhood couldn't stand it, and the city council wanted to do something about it, and people wanted to change that scenario for the better. I really love to see a bad property be put to good use. I'm Rebecca Bourdon. I'm a hydrogeologist. I basically conduct technical reviews on leak sites and on redevelopment projects. A typical day at my job consists of pretty much office work, but we do conduct site visits as often as we can, and we go out and just take a look and make sure that what we're seeing on paper matches with what we're seeing on the field. In reality, we really work quite a bit with a number of mapping programs and database programs, as well as simple conversations between project teams and our supervisors. And we do a bit of work with our guidance to make sure that what the work that's being done is being done adequately. I have a Bachelor of Science in Geology from North Dakota State University. I'm also a certified professional geologist in the state of Minnesota, which is a two-part exam. You take one part when you're just exiting college, and that's the fundamentals of geology, and then you take a professional geologist exam a few years later after you've gained some in-field experience. Somebody who has the ability to bring it all together, somebody who can take a technical detail and combine that with some of the site concerns or people aspects of a project. When you can bring all of those sort of things together and work well with your project team, I think you bring an ability to make very good, very efficient decisions. The computer, of course, is primary to my function as a hydro. We really rely on a number of programs, the mapping programs, ArcGIS, any kind of GIS software. Really, we have a great deal of training on and exposure and resources. If you're on the job site, if you were doing some field work in particular, a series of sampling equipment and monitoring equipment. Beyond the obvious nature of remediation and cleanup, I think this job particularly has an opportunity to make very intelligent decisions in terms of cleanups that need to be done and cleanups that do not need to be done. In particular, petroleum is a degradable product. It will naturally degrade over time, and in certain scenarios, we allow that to happen, and we're actually saving a larger carbon footprint, if you think about it in a holistic sense, by not expending a number of resources to get to a site, to investigate it, only to realize that, yes, indeed, it can be left. A typical misconception certainly is that it's kind of a man's job or a male-dominated profession. While that balance is getting better, it's certainly something that is very open for females to enter. I really do see a flux or a change in the workforce itself, because we have so many of the boomer generation getting close to or actually at the retirement age right now, that I see a great deal of possibility and opportunity for the middle to younger generations to fill those positions. Passion for it is pivotal, and experience can be sought. You can get the experience. There are many internships, there's many student worker positions. If you're in the middle of your career and you want to take a hard left, or you want to make a big career change, I think it's possible to do. You can be a person who brings a number of skills to bear, and as long as you can apply that to the job appropriately, I think you can really succeed.